need my bitch in the apron. Booty all out cooking bacon.
Cooking bacon. All right. Welcome to another podcast, Talking Noise.
We're always talking the noise.
With G.A. Anderson and Uncle Chewy.
Oh, really?
All right, man. This is an impromptu.
Impromptu
podcast.
I had to.
Yeah.
We had to.
I got a call. Actually, I didn't get a call. I got a text.
Yeah.
I got a text message saying, you ready to do a podcast? We just did a podcast last week.
Exactly.
This is a big turnaround.
This is as quickly as we've ever turned around a podcast before.
So you said, are you ready to do a podcast? Like, why? What's up? And you said that the NBA games are canceled.
Yeah. I said the Rockets game.
I had heard about the Bucks being canceled.
Right.
Now, and then I turn on the TV, and I see, oh, the Rockets are playing. Because I thought maybe the Bucks just walked off. They didn't want to play, so they canceled that game.
Right.
I turn on the TNT, and I see no game on.
Right.
No Rockets. Right. And then I'm like, wait a minute.
What the? Yeah. You're like, hey, what's going on here? I'm like,
yeah, this is serious.
I'm like, that's what I said. There is literally no game being played.
Yeah, so I don't, like, for me, I'm just kind of like, what the hell? This is crazy. I mean, I understand they're protesting.
Okay.
So okay.
My day.
Go ahead and explain what your deal is, what the dilemma is for you.
So, you know, the last game, I hadn't heard about this Wisconsin shooting. The last Rockets game, Chris Paul came out, so they won. He explained what happened.
I think it was the day of.
He mentioned, what happened. And I was like, oh, Wisconsin, what happened? And I actually watched the video. I was like, oh, my God.
Yeah.
That's egregious. Like, that's, whoa. I was astounded. I was appalled. And I was like, this is getting outrageous.
You see the guy walking away. So the backstory is he went there to break up a fight.
Correct.
That's what it was. Two women are having a fight. He went to go break it up.
Correct.
The cops, I think in the video there was like three or four of them.
There was three of them that were standing around him. He turned his back to start to walk away. All three
to get back in his car.
They all three pulled their weapons.
Right. Their guns.
Yeah.
Not a taser.
Yes. They're actual guns. And he walks around and he goes around to open the driver's side of the door.
Yeah.
And the cop grabs him by like the T-shirt or the arm or whatnot. Grabs him and then shoots him, proceeds to shoot him seven times in the back. Seven times, not once. Like, when I watched it, I was...
Was it one officer that shot him?
It was just one.
It was the guy, right?
Just one cop followed him around the car, watched him try to
get... Because I saw there was three of them.
When he turned his back, there was three that pulled their weapon, their guns.
Right.
And he walked around the front of the vehicle to come around to the driver's side of the vehicle, and then... one of the officers followed him around and grabbed him by his shirt or his armpit or whatever and proceeded to shoot him seven times in the back.
Okay.
Luckily, he's still alive.
He is still alive.
He's in. He went from critical condition to serious condition.
Here we go. Let's play this real quick. Okay,
seven.
Yeah. So it was one guy. It was one
cop. One guy. Seven shots.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah. So there's two cops that were following him as he's walking around his car, and he gets into his vehicle.
He attempted to get into his vehicle.
He almost made it.
Yeah, he didn't actually get in the he almost in the made car. It. And, he got shot and, seven times.
And I guess this cop decided that he was going to make a run for it. You're not getting away from me.
Not today, sir.
No, sir.
Not today.
I don't think so.
I see those car keys. That's
right. Oh, he's got car keys.
And on top of that, there's three children in the back seat that actually witnessed this happen.
Okay, I didn't know that part.
There's three children in the back seat of his vehicle that he's trying to get into.
Were they his children?
Who cares? They're children. Like,
to the cop, it might have mattered. Okay. Maybe he thought they were being kidnapped.
Well, okay. Maybe that he had
plain devil's advocate.
His rules of engagement were
his rules
shoot him seven times if there's kids in the back.
Exactly.
I don't know.
Yeah. Who knows?
Who knows? He could have been kidnapping the kids.
True.
Who knows? Yeah, that's aside the point. That's not the point where I contacted you about doing this podcast.
So let's go. Then let's talk about that. Why did you contact me?
Well, so today I'm mowing the lawn, doing lawn work. I want to hurry up and get it done so I can sit down, grab my beer, and watch a Rockets game.
Rock. Okay, what about the Bucks? Were you interested in the Bucks?
Who cares about the Bucks? I live in Houston.
I don't know if it was NBA basketball you wanted to watch, or just, you know, just your home team. Okay, that's fine.
Just yeah.
Okay, home team.
As if it matters, but
I enjoy watching Giannis.
Okay, well, that's too bad.
Okay,
you live in Houston, but
that's okay. So go. So what happened?
So I get home. You know, I'm done. You know, doing the lawn, everything. My wife tells me, Rockets are boycotting. I'm like, what do you mean? Game is postponed. I'm like, postponed? Postponed for what?
Yeah.
Oh, because of that shooting in Wisconsin.
Right. They're tired.
The shooting in Wisconsin. I'm like, how is that stopping them from playing? Like, I don't...
Well, they're trying to make a statement.
And this is my point.
Okay.
They're making a statement how?
By not playing, and they're going to show the public that...
But me, a hardworking man... Black man. Okay. I want to sit down and watch a fucking Rockets game.
Right.
But I can't do it because these players decided they don't want to play because they disagree with what took place.
Okay. Is that not a good platform to protest in your eyes?
Absolutely not. I mean, it's not even a platform at all. You can't even call that a platform. That's not a platform to protest. That's not even a protest. That's just them not wanting to play just because they feel bad about something.
But like, they're protesting.
How do you... Okay, let's define protesting.
Okay. You define it.
Protesting...
I already know what it means, but you define it.
Protesting being, I disagree with something, right. So I'm going to speak out about it.
You're right.
It doesn't mean I'm going to stop doing my job, which is to entertain the public. Look, I'm sitting here, nothing against my family.
Right.
But I got...
Which side? The white or the black family?
Both sides.
Okay.
I got both families.
Exactly.
And only thing I want to do is just sit down on the couch and watch some basketball.
Okay.
So if you want to protest, do it on our actual platform. Go vote. Go talk. Send a letter to your senator. Do something, but not do your job. How is that? All you're doing is affecting me. I'm sitting on the couch with my beer, and like now I'm watching. What are we watching? This stupid ass movie on TNT.
Yeah, they switched it to The Longest Yard.
Yeah, really? This is not what I signed up for. But you're getting paid millions of dollars, and you. This is not a protest. This is just you not doing your job.
Right.
And
even though they don't get paid, or do they get paid
for not doing their job?
Right.
Who gives a shit? They ain't starving, I promise you that.
Right.
They ain't starving. So, if you want to... let's look at Colin Kaepernick.
Right. We've discussed this before.
Exactly. We're bringing it back up.
And you didn't like that, you know, he was using...
Exactly. And what did he accomplish? It's gotten worse since he fucking started taking a knee.
Right.
Not that it's his fault, but it's gotten even worse. So... Oh, I'm not going to play until things change. Well, what has changed?
Right.
Guess what? Nothing. It's gotten even worse. So you guys not playing? What are you accomplishing? How is this a protest? How is this standing on your morals? This is... You're just not playing basketball. It's not solving anything. Come to me. Do something for... Look for a solution. Don't just... I'm not going to do something that makes people happy and then call it a protest. No, it's not a protest.
So that's not it.
That's you being a selfish fucking piece of entitled shit. And I may be one of the good ones / bad ones. So on the black people side, they're like, oh, why are you bashing black people for not playing basketball? And the white people were like, you're being a good one for, like, denouncing this.
Oh, yeah. The white people love you right now.
Oh, of course. Yeah. But let's just...
But you're just trying to...
Let's objectify it.
You're making sense of it all.
Exactly. Like, let's not emotion take over, like, Republican, Democrat. No. I want to watch a basketball game. Your job is to play basketball. Your job is not to tell me societal civil right movement fucking shit, because it's not going to change anything. By not playing basketball, you just made things worse.
How so?
Because now I can't watch basketball. Now I'm irate. So, now I'm even more angry.
So now you want to go loot.
Exactly. Now I want to go fucking throw bricks through NBA players' windows.
Typical black man. Now it's you're right. You want to go loot.
I know. Angry guy. What can I do? I'm black. I have no choice.
You have no choice. Now you
have to.
You know, the white people loved you for a split second, but now you're going to go loot.
No, they're like, oh, he's one of those. Damn it.
He's back into the Democrat side.
Okay. I don't think blacks are on any side. They're just blacks. That's it.
Right.
But however, blacks, if we want to come up as people,
yeah,
by not playing basketball is not the way to go about it. Like,
right.
You entitled assholes. They have one job to do.
Right.
I don't look to LeBron James, Chris Paul, fucking Harden. I don't look to them for my moral compass. They're good athletes. They don't have shit to do with fucking shooting in Wisconsin.
Yeah.
So them fucking stop playing basketball accomplishes absolutely, what does it accomplish?
Zero.
Yeah. But great, thanks guys.
So what would you say would be a good way for them to express their disgust with what, you know, with the shootings and everything that's been going on? What would be a good way to go about it rather than just like not playing basketball?
Well, they should play basketball.
Okay.
Okay. One. Two, they should start, take their whole entire paycheck and contribute it to actual nonprofit programs that actually help. Okay. Here's another thing I'm going to get on.
Okay.
Defunding police departments? Absurd.
Exactly, yes.
Absurd. Like,
maybe give some of that game check to pay for more training.
Yeah.
These cops?
Yeah.
I mean, there was three of them that should have been able to subdue this one man.
Yeah, easily.
But maybe with more training, they would have been able to...
Maybe we could weed out, like, the worst.
The crap.
Exactly. Maybe we should put money into that as opposed to, I'm just not going to play basketball. That's not going to solve anything. I'm just going to take a knee. Well, yeah. What did you accomplish, Colin Kaepernick? You lost your job, and then now things are worse. So,
yeah.
I understand, like, starting a conversation, that's great. But once you start that conversation, we have to move forward with that conversation. We can't just...
And there was no moving forward.
There was no, like, actions. There's no resolution, like, what we're looking for. There's no gain. There's no, like, here's what we want.
It's just people, like, taking their ball away and just saying, I'm not going to play ball anymore.
I'm not going to play. Okay, yeah. How does that help anything?
It doesn't. They walk away from the situation.
And not only does it affect them and their families, because they're not getting paid now.
Right.
It affects everyone that wants to sit down and take their mind off COVID, fucking Laura, fucking...
2020.
Exactly. All we want to do is watch you guys play basketball, which you're getting paid handsomely for. But you can't even do that?
Because I think the thing is, it's more than just white cops that are watching basketball.
Of course. Obviously. Obviously.
So who are you punishing by walking off the court?
Absolutely. The fans.
Are you? Exactly. But, I mean, how many white cops are watching basketball?
And it's a small percentage. And
probably.
Who gives a shit?
Exactly. So.
So you're not... You're only punishing the fans. So I was irate.
You're mad. You were angry.
I was. I was like, we need to do an impromptu. Like, we don't
get this the mics ready. I'm coming over.
I need to talk about this. I need to get this off my chest because this is some. And all you fuckers that want to fucking, I'm not gonna play basketball. Well, fuck you. Oh, and then TNT today.
Yeah.
Kenny the Jet Smith.
Former Houston Rocket.
Houston Rocket.
Championship cries winner
and walks off the stage.
Yeah, I wish I would have. I didn't see that.
What the fuck are you crying about? Did he kill one of your family members?
Did he say anything? Kenny Smith?
No, he just did this. Took his glasses off, grabbed his nose, and walked away. And then Chris Webber is crying on the fucking screen like he fucking gives a shit. You're still getting paid millions.
You're right.
He should be crying because he's not gonna get paid because there's no game fucking going on. Not about fucking this. The civil.
How about this? Since Kenny angered you a little bit, let's listen to his little speech.
Yeah, let's hear it.
All right.
Right now, my head is like ready to explode. Mm-hmm. Like, just in the thoughts of what's going on. And I don't know if I'm even appropriate enough to say it. What the players are feeling and how they're feeling. And I haven't talked to any of the players. I'm just... But like coming in, even like driving here and getting into the studio, hearing calls and people talking, And for me, I think the biggest thing now is to kind of, as a black man, as a former player, I think it's best for me to support the players and just not be here tonight. Oh,
taking off his mic.
And walk away. He's not going to do his job either. Yeah.
Keep your mic on until you're actually done talking.
Yeah, yeah. Take it off. Wait.
And I respect that.
There goes Ernie.
Ernie, shut up. You don't... You...
When does he cry? Oh, here he goes. He walks off.
You up out of bitch.
He starts crying.
The fuck out of here. Do your fucking job. Come on, man.
Call the game.
Everyone should just quit their jobs, I guess.
Yeah.
Everyone in the United States of America should just quit their jobs.
Yeah.
Somehow that'll solve, that'll make social justice take place.
It's just the way things are right now.
I know.
You cry about it. If you cry about it enough,
things will change.
Things will change.
If you take a knee, things will change.
You cry about it enough, it might. It's worked with other things.
Like what? When you're 5 years old, you want a toy?
Yeah, well, that's kind of how it works. You could say that the far left cries a lot about all kinds of shit. And you know they're starting to get their way.
Yeah.
Well, you know there's so many
well, listen,
things to talk about there. I don't want to get into.
Yeah.
Piss people off even more.
I also asked my wife. I was like, does this make me a bad black person? Because I'm not.
Because you're not right with them.
Yeah, I'm not like I'm gonna quit my job.
Well, it just makes you it shows that you're a thinker.
I would like to think about the.
You're thinking about. You know what they're doing and how just it doesn't make a difference. You're trying to make a difference, or you're saying like, look, we can make a difference, but not going about it this way.
That's not how we do it. Right. I think about, I mean, you and I doing this, even though it might be 9 people that hear it, this makes more of a difference than Kenny Smith walking off. Or you want to do the Weber, Chris Weber supposedly crying on the. Fucking yeah, I agree with them for not playing. What the fuck? How is that changing anything? No.
He kind of said the same thing as Kenny Smith. Yeah.
His agent's in the background going, I need you to get some tears. Get some tears.
Chris, can you tear up for us for a second?
Tears up. He's like, yeah, I need to make money.
Here he goes.
Yeah.
If not now, when?
No.
If not during a pandemic.
Okay. Come on. Isn't that 1962?
Count my eyes being lost. If not now, when?
Yeah.
Come on. That's
if not now,
rest in life, when?
That's a song.
Pastor Weber.
That's a song. That's a song.
What are we all just going to get along?
Martin Luther King got shot and risked his life. Mega Evers. If we've
do not make that comparison.
Constantly taken down. We understand it's not going to end. But that does not mean, young men, that you don't do anything. Don't listen to these people telling you don't do anything because it's not going to end right away. You are starting something for the next generation and the next generation.
He's talking to you, Mr. Anderson.
Do you have to be smart? Yes. Yeah. Do you have to make sure that you have a plan? Yes. Do you have to be articulate about that plan? Yes.
Yes.
All of those things. But that's what you're going to do. They're professionals. They know how to be the best of themselves.
Agents like tears now.
And so I applaud it.
Tears now.
I applaud it because it is
Chris, don't forget
people.
The tears.
It is the young people leading the way, and I applaud them.
Okay.
Chris, that was great. If you could just do one more time and give us a little bit more tears.
Remember that time that timeout?
We didn't.
Michigan, remember that?
Chris, just think about the timeout that you called in the Michigan game. Yeah.
And you blamed it on everyone else.
Start tearing up and then we'll be okay.
Okay.
It'll be great.
Yeah,
we'll
be great. You're good. You look good.
You look great, Chris.
Take your headphones off. Take your headphones off. And wipe your eyes. Shut the fuck up, Chris. You know better. Come on.
Oh, come on.
Come on, man. If we're going to do something, let's do it right. That's all I got to say.
So how would you do it right? What would be the right?
Well, let's run for office.
Yeah.
Let's.
LeBron should run for office. What's with the look?
No, LeBron can't run for office.
No?
No.
He's popular.
He can't even take a stand on his own fucking 2 feet. He will do whatever is good for the media.
Yeah.
Whatever is good for his marketing, whatever is good for, looks good if I say this. But he won't take an actual stand. He won't say, like, have you seen him not try to play basketball? Even if he did, it would be stupid.
He's going to now.
Well, after everyone else has done it.
Exactly.
Okay, so we'll get back to the root of the Black Lives Matter.
Okay.
Which we've already spoke about.
Right. Racism in America podcast, 2 episodes ago. Check it out.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can listen
to
it.
This is a follow-up. Like, I'm trying to... Because I'm tired of it. I'm sick and tired of it. And somebody needs to say something. Like, I don't understand why nobody's saying something but me. Like...
Yeah.
They're gonna be like, "Oh, he's just one of those."
He's the easy Uncle Tom.
Exactly. I'm like, no, I'm one of the revolution. I want to be a revolutionary. I want to.
Right.
I want to make actual change, not just make
talk
change
about
that.
It.
Exactly. Talk about it. Like,
talk about it.
This is Black Lives Matter. Okay?
Give me my ball. I'm leaving, and we're gonna talk about
exactly.
it.
Exactly.
Let's go talk about it.
Okay, let's talk about it. No, my agent says we can't talk about it at this point. Like, no. Well,
right.
you didn't play basketball. For what reason?
Okay.
I want change. Okay, how do you want that change to be instituted?
So how would George Anderson, the ball player, handle this? George Anderson, you play for the Rockets.
I'd be on the court shooting.
You'd be on the court shooting. Mm-hmm. They say, well, don't you see what's going on? How come you don't agree with the protest? You've already explained that part, so how would you change it?
I would change it. I would.
What would be a way to go about it by changing it?
Well, politics. Unfortunately, that's the way we have to go about it in this
politics.
Country.
Okay.
There's the only way you can make a change. The NBA has enough money, or at least the players have enough money, to create not a Black Lives Matter, but an actual change. Create positive type nonprofit institutions.
Like a program, yeah.
Exactly. Programs or force the police academies or whatever, whoever it is that train these police to have a more of a train, like
just some sort of system in place to train these police officers how to just, I guess, handle
situations.
Like what we've seen. For instance, like to George Floyd, there was, I think it was 2 or 3 cops there.
Stood around.
They couldn't subdue this one gentleman.
They even stopped people from trying to stop it.
Right.
Like, so there should be something in place to where that things like that shouldn't take place. So you shouldn't have the kid that graduated high school that was fucking beat up and bullied. He hates black people, Mexicans, and whatever.
Right.
And allow him to become a police officer, because guess what's going to happen? He's going to take that authority.
He's going
to
shoot some black guy 7 times in the back.
For no apparent reason.
Like, yes, I was like, dude, you
needs
relax.
To be, okay.
Yeah. No, no, I'm talking
about... Oh, okay,
about
I was like, me.
Not you.
Like,
no, okay. You keep going.
Okay. But, yeah, there needs to be things put in place.
Yeah.
Instituted in the training academy and weed out those type of people.
Mm-hmm. Like,
no, they just accept anybody. Like, hey, you want to be a cop? Cool. Oh, you're a racist? Whatever. We don't care. You're an anarchist? Cool.
Yeah.
That's fine. Like, no, that's not fine. Okay? So we need to do things to, like, not playing basketball is not going to change.
Right.
Well, institutional racism, which is basically, if you want to get down to brass tacks, it's institutional racism.
Define that.
Institutional racism means, like, okay, status quo. It means, like, the haves and the have-nots. So the haves don't want the nots to have any more than they have. Okay.
Right.
What just...
White and black. You're saying that.
Have, white and minority.
Yeah.
It doesn't have to be black.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, I appreciate you lumping me in there. Thank you.
Yeah.
The forgotten race.
You gotta be mad, too.
The forgotten race.
Well, you're not mad. You're like, yeah, I'll stay at Home Depot. I got kicked out of the fucking
<That's> what,
inside of the store.
That's what Mexicans do best. We just put our head down.
Yeah, let's go back to work.
Yeah. Let them fight it out. We'll just go.
Yeah,
we'll just do our thing over here.
Keep doing our thing. No, that's not fine. That's not okay.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to weed out the bad ones. And
right.
And there has to be implemented something, some sort of program that says, like, okay, here's one thing I read in WSJ, Wall Street Journal.
Oh, shit. Go ahead.
Yeah.
Look
at you.
Mr. Academia over here.
Open your ears, nigga.
How come you ain't reading Esquire?
I know. Why you not... Why are you not protesting the street? Why are you not breaking windows?
Hey, why don't you pick up a Jet magazine once in a while? No.
No. Say it with your chest.
Say it with your chest. All right, what did the Wall Street Journal say?
Well, it said, So as far as the higher ups for the cops,
right?
Whoever's not making a certain requirement for as far as performance goes, mm-hmm. fired. Those that are doing well, promoted.
Oh, these are their suggestions on training.
Suggestion,
and
yes. Okay. So right now, as it is,
that's not in place.
Even the guys that killed what's the guy that was jogging?
Wait. What you mean? The one that happened in Atlanta or in Georgia?
Yeah.
Well, those weren't cops that killed him.
I know. He was a former cop.
Was he?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. I didn't know that.
Well, either way.
Him and his son, right? It was him and his son.
Yeah, and his son.
Yeah.
He was a former cop. Either way, the bureaucracy behind and the union behind cops, they're going to try to keep your job no matter what.
Yeah. Yeah, I remember you said that.
They're gonna try to keep your job. Like, even if you shoot someone in the face for no apparent reason, like, they're right. going to try to keep your job. Like,
yeah. Cheney.
Yeah. Like, that's institutional
right.
racism. Like, we can't change anything yeah. until we start changing that.
Okay.
Until we get underground and, like, exactly. root out all this type of fucking nonsense. That
so, you call it institutional racism. What I've always heard it called is the good old boy system.
That's institutional racism. That's, okay. You just said it in a different way.
Yeah. I mean, that's what I'm saying. Like, I've always heard it as the good old boy system.
Good old
system.
Boy system. Yeah. So, yeah. But it's impossible.
It's impossible to get in the good old boy system.
Yeah, it's impossible. Yeah. You can't.
Unless one of the good old boys marries like your sister or something.
Yeah, then they might have a little different. Maybe yeah. they'll consider.
I'll get my brother-in-law in.
Yeah. He's one of the good ones now.
He's one of the good
ones. We'll bring him in. Like, no, yeah. that's not what.
He don't have any tattoos. He's all right.
Well, we got a black commissioner here. Black commissioner's still answering to somebody.
Yeah.
Until. Which will never happen. I'm gonna make that clear.
What's that?
It's institutional racism for a reason. Mm-hmm. Because it's an institution that's been established in this country.
Right.
And it's never going to change.
Yeah.
Short of an actual revolution. A revolution is not stopping playing basketball. A revolution is civil rights movement in the 60s.
Okay.
That's a civil right. That's
a change.
That's a change. Like, we can't sit at your restaurant, so we're going to sit here in civil disobedience. We're not going to mm-hmm. fight anybody, but we're going to still sit in your restaurant, even yeah. though we're not allowed here.
So, in this case, would the actions and the, I guess, the protests taken at, say, police buildings, you know, where they're they're lighting them on fire. I mean, is that something that...
No. Okay.
Would that be civil disobedience?
No, absolutely not. That's like civil... just rioting. That's not...
Right.
Martin Luther King didn't stand for rioting. He was always about nonviolent protests.
Right.
The protests that are going down are just... They're violent protests. And then it turns out poorly, because there's actually no accomplishment there.
Mm-hmm.
Like, we just fucking go destroy some shit. Or accomplishment when not playing basketball, what'd yeah. you accomplish? Zero. Colin Kaepernick, what'd you accomplish? Zero. Defunding police departments, what are you accomplishing? Zero.
Right.
Not every cop is a bad cop, but you can't throw out the baby with the bathwater.
Right. Yeah, well, I think that's it's a good point. Education,
well,
is what you're kind of saying. We need more education. People need to just be educated. I mean, how do you get like say like one of these racists to understand that you are being dumb by treating people based on their skin color? You have to educate them.
We also have to educate those people that are of skin color. True. You can't go out and start tearing shit down.
Yeah.
MLK didn't say go out and fucking throw bricks through windows and kick light fires. Like, he never said that. Like, so by doing that, like, we're both fucking butting heads, and it's...
Yeah.
Guess where we're going? Nowhere.
Hmm.
We're going nowhere. So we need to sit down.
We're making George mad because there's no Rockets game.
Exactly. That's literally what it comes down
We're
to.
We're not going anywhere. We're just making George mad.
Exactly. And everybody should listen to me. But honestly, I mean, like, we can't move forward if we're just going
right.
to if it's going to be violent about it.
So for those that are listening and maybe questioning, well, what does this black guy know? What's this? Tell him your background. Like what does you studied stuff like this in school?
Yes. So my undergrad is in sociology.
Okay.
Okay. So then I worked for white folks in an engineering company.
Mm-hmm.
I made my way up through the ranks.
Right.
And was still making $13 an hour while basically working as an engineer in California. Got bored, got my master's degree in humanities.
Okay.
So I've done a lot of reading. I've done a lot of writing.
Yeah.
And I think I have a little bit better perspective than $1 million point guard. Sorry, but I have to fucking put it out like that. Like, Chris Paul, fucking, whoever the fuck. Like,
right.
Go make your fucking money. Make the fans happy. That's your job.
Well, didn't Chris Paul attend a prestigious college?
I don't know if he did or not. Who cares? Because I'm trying to think of what college he went to, but
I don't know.
Gives a shit.
I just want to say, didn't he go to college?
Yeah, for basketball. And now he's quitting his job.
Now he's quitting basketball.
Yeah, okay. For what?
Yeah.
So you have to ask that question. For what? By the NBA, the players, mm-hmm. boycotting playing basketball, what are you accomplishing? You have to think about it. You have to sit down and you have to go, okay, I want change. So mm-hmm. how do I go about getting change? Me quitting my job is... So the firefighters quit being firefighters? They quit their job? Is that going to affect change? No, there's going to be fires that kill people. That's right. It.
Well, all that and just, you know, they answer. They're the first responders on every call.
All first responders. Should they quit their job as well? Just like basketball players are?
Yeah.
In order to affect change? Is that gonna change anything? Like, I don't.
Doesn't make sense.
Does it make sense? I'm asking
you.
No, I'm
saying it doesn't.
It doesn't make sense.
It doesn't make sense.
So
I'm saying you got a good point.
Oh, well,
how's that?
Thank you.
How's that?
Thank you.
We're gonna agree on something today.
I'm just angry black man today.
You're just angry black man.
I'm just angry black man.
We'll agree on. Agree to disagree.
Agree to agree.
Agree to agree. Well, is there anything else you'd like to get off your chest? While we have the audience right now.
Oh, also, yes, I do. My wife said something to me today. She's like, so we defund
mm-hmm.
the police departments.
Yeah.
Now what do we have? And she was like,
chaos.
This is anarchy.
Right.
Is that what we really want? She goes, it's going to be like the purge. I'm like, well, that's actually a good point.
Yeah.
Really? We want the purge? Let's run around and just kill people for a night. That'll get us out of our system.
Possibly.
I hope. Oh, let's try it then. I guarantee you, I won't die.
They made it a movie for a reason.
They're making a lot of movies for a reason. Maybe not for a good reason, but
right.
But still, there's a premise there that kind of chimes in. It's like,
yeah.
What do you want? If you don't want cops at all. Okay, so when you are in trouble, not that...
Who are you going to call?
Exactly. Not that I trust the police. And that's another thing I want to... I'm actually scared for my life now.
Mm-hmm.
If I get pulled over, I'm like, I might die. I literally might die.
Right. So you have that feeling.
Just now, yeah.
Yeah.
After the Wisconsin thing, I've finally come to the point where I'm like...
Like, you feel like if you might get pulled over, and if...
I might get my life taken. I've been beaten up. I'm like... I told my wife, I was like, what happened to the days of just beating up Rodney King and then we move on? Like, now it's to the days where it's like, you get killed.
it's getting worse.
Yeah, you just get killed. Like, there's no getting beat down. Like, you just get killed.
Well, it's easier for them to just cover it up because the other person can't say anything.
Because they're dead.
Exactly.
But Rodney King, for some reason they had a camera. I don't know. But
somebody had a camera.
Yeah, but there was like before cell phones. Like, I don't even know how that happened, but... On this, you know, in the same sense, like, it's like, if I get pulled over, I might, this cop might have a fucking, might just be like,
mm-hmm.
this nigger needs to die. And I'm like, I don't, sir.
Yeah.
Last time I got my shins beat down.
Right.
I survived that. But the next time, I might not. And that irks me. I'm scared for my life now.
Like, right.
Which I've never been before. I'm like,
because some guy just gonna be having a bad day till you get out of your car and you're gonna question it because that's the type of person you are. It was like, yeah. Why am I?
I served my country. I've gone to school. Like, I've done all the right things. Like,
why am I being treated like this?
Exactly. Well, institutional racism. But
right. But he doesn't care.
He doesn't give a shit. No. He has a bad day. So he's like,
I got a bad day.
I have this badge and I have this weapon. I have this gun. I have this taser. Oh, fuck the taser. I'm gonna use my gun.
You know what I'm gonna do? I did seasonal work at Home Depot. I think I want to just join the academy and just we can document and podcast that experience as well.
That'd be awesome. That'd be awesome. I'd be like, hey, you're good.
There's got to be a police department in one of these neighboring towns that'll hire me.
If they don't hear this.
If they don't hear this. Maybe I'll cut this part out and then I'll add it in later. Yeah.
After you get fired or after you kill someone.
Yeah, after I kill someone. I'm not going to say that.
Well, let's see. Let's see when white people start getting killed.
That's the real change.
Why is it black people's... You remember before, a couple years ago, it was like Black Lives Matter. Like, everybody's lives matters. Yeah. Why has that changed? Like, nobody's
They still say that.
Not as much as they used
to. All lives matter, that's what they say.
No, those coaches on the fucking basketball court just say Black Lives Matter. They're wearing their jerseys.
Like, you're saying, like, the white people are saying it now or something? What are you...
They're not saying, like, all lives matter anymore. Mm-hmm. Not as much as they used to. Now it's like Black Lives Matter is an actual movement. Like, you can wear it on your jersey. They put it on basketball courts, like...
Oh, yeah,
Matter.
But like, you mean, like, before they were just... People were just kind of annoyed of it.
Yeah, until George Floyd. Then it turned into, like, now Black Lives do matter. Like, what took place to make that change? Like, from all lives matter, and then George Floyd dies. Now all of a sudden, you know what it's called?
What's that?
Appeasement.
Appeasement. Mm-hmm. We're gonna give y'all something, and y'all can just y'all take it.
So you will calm the fuck down. that's pretty much.
You don't have to give it to them.
Yeah. Hey, give them the right to vote, so they won't fucking revolt.
Yeah.
So like,
What was that? You posted a quote about being docile. What's that supposed to mean?
I had to break it down. Like,
what's the quote? Do you have it?
Yeah.
I can pull it up if you need to. Pull it up.
That was funny. Yeah. Docile.
Beware of a black man.
Yeah. Beware when they turn their fucking heads and decide that they actually want to do something about it.
Let me see. Here it goes. So. You posted this quote. It said, "Is by Langston Hughes."
Langston Hughes, yeah.
Negroes, sweet and docile, meek, humble, and kind. Beware the day they change their mind. Langston Hughes. Mm-hmm. And then there's a few comments. And
What does that mean?
Of course, it was a white man in here. What does this mean?
What are you doing here? What are you still doing here?
A white man has to read that and say, well, what does that mean?
What do you mean? What does it mean?
Are you going to revolt?
It explained, right what I explained.
Exactly. And then I went ahead and put, you're one of the good ones.
You're one of the good ones.
I said mine as a joke, and people got mad at it. I guess
what? It's a joke, man. Come on.
Yeah, he's trying to protect you.
Okay. I'm one of the good ones. You got to protect me.
Yeah.
Man, you got to keep him close. Keep me close.
But yeah, I saw that quote and I thought that was pretty funny. Just the first response was from a white man.
I know. I thought it was a poignant statement. And what does that mean? Exactly.
It means they're getting mad.
Exactly. After explaining that to you,
something's about to happen. Yeah. And
but we're going about the wrong way.
Yeah.
Not playing basketball is not the way to go about it.
No.
I mean, if you want to make change, not playing basketball is...
Yeah. Well, maybe they're just changing their mind and not playing basketball.
Wait till that paycheck stops coming in.
They'll change your mind again.
Exactly. They'll start playing again.
I guess we better play.
I guess, get back on the court. Langston Hughes. Langston Hughes wasn't playing point guard for goddamn Oklahoma City Thunder. Like, come on.
So here's the thing. So these guys, I mean, it's like you said, The paychecks. If once the paychecks stop, they're gonna change their mind.
Absolutely.
So it's kind
of money talks, bullshit walks.
And it's, yeah, so it shows that it's bullshit.
Exactly.
It's probably just gonna be one game.
Yeah.
You know, they're only doing it for one game. So what's the point?
Exactly. Yeah. What is the point? Like, what are you changing by not playing today? I know what you changed. I couldn't sit down and drink a beer and watch a fucking basketball.
Well,
game.
They're saying we're making a statement. We're not gonna play, and people are gonna listen.
Statements are great, they're awesome, but just play the basketball game. You can make statements like
but that's what I'm saying. That's what they're going to say. Is like we it was one game.
Shouldn't they
but that one game made a statement because it enraged people and people are now talking about it.
Okay, it's a conversation starter.
Right.
Look how it turned out for Colin Kaepernick.
Right.
Nick, it still ain't working. He still ain't got no job.
Okay.
He made a statement, and things have gotten actually worse since he made that so quote-unquote statement.
He was also...
He started that quote-unquote conversation. Things have gotten worse.
He was also benched
okay.
at the time, and you know, I did think he just needed an outlet.
Well, let's do... If you want an outlet, let's do it right.
Yeah.
Let's do it right.
You got a good Nike deal.
Let's go to our congressmen. Let's go to our senators. Let's go to the president. Let's fucking... Yeah. Let's raise hell in the politic world.
Right.
Not playing basketball is not going to change shit. It's just you're not playing basketball. You're not getting paid. The fans getting pissed off, like myself.
Mm-hmm.
And, next week there'll be another shooting. It's like, oh, thanks, guys.
Yeah.
No, I can't watch basketball and there's more shootings. Like, what the fuck?
So, yeah, I need this next shooting that's about to happen, I need something to take my mind off of it. So, get back on the court.
Exactly. Keep playing. So, when I get killed, yeah. I can at least say, like, the Rockets won the series. But I can't even say that. I'll just get killed.
Okay. Understand. Got it.
Too much for you?
No, I get it. Good stuff.
Good stuff.
All right, man. So...
I had to get it off my chest.
You got it off your chest. I think you made it pretty clear. I got it.
You got it?
Everybody
listening got it.
Like, I understand where you're coming from.
Good.
And it makes total sense. Walking off the court, not playing for a game, doesn't do anything.
Doesn't accomplish shit.
Exactly.
Like, oh, no. Police shootings are going to stop because you guys stopped playing basketball?
Right.
Come on.
You know, maybe use that game check that they're not going to pay you and put it towards something that'll...
Some nonprofit organization that'll help train cops to not kill black people. I don't know. Maybe that.
Maybe a brown person, too. You know?
Oh, yeah, you too, guys. You're not really in the news. So
we're just stuck in cages down south.
Exactly. Keep your head down. Jesus.
Just give them one of those space blankets and they'll be fine.
Yeah. If you do get established enough, you'll be killed. Don't worry about it. So let's stop it right now before you guys start getting killed, too.
True. All right. Well.
All right. Cheers, man.
Cheers to
Talking Noise.
Cheers to Talking Noise and black people.